ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை ஃபோர்த் பாசுரம். ஆழிமழை கண்ணா ஒன்று நீ கை கரவேல், ஆழி உள் பொக்கு முகுந்து குடாத்தேரி, ஊழி முதல்வன் உருவம் போல் மெய் கருத்து, பாழியன் தோளுடை பத்மநாபன் கையில், ஆழி போல் மிந்தி வலம் புரி போல் நின்றதிர்ந்து, தாழாதே சார்ங்க முதைத்த சரமழை போல், வாழ உலகினில் பெய்திடாய் நாங்களும், மார்கழி நீராட மகிழ்ந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் ஹேட் கால்ட் அவுட் டு ஆல் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் டு பெர்ஃபார்ம் த பாவை நோம்பு, அண்ட் ஷீ டோல்ட் தெம் த டூஸ் அண்ட் த டோன்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் த பாவை நோம்பு, அண்ட் ஆல்சோ வாட் த வேர்ல்ட் வுட் ரிசீவ் ஆஸ் அ பெனிஃபிட் by their doing the pavai nombu. Now when she was telling about the benefits that the world would enjoy, one of her friends had a doubt. Aandaal had said that the world would be blessed with abundant rains. Now just because we are saying, would it be possible that actually rain would shower on the world? Would the god in charge of rain actually listen to them? She had this doubt in her mind and was about to ask Aandaal when these girls suddenly saw that there was a person standing beside their meeting area. Who was this? Aandaal recognized him and called out to him, Aazhi mazhaik anna. Aazhi mazhaik anna is an address. She addressed the person as Aazhi mazhaik anna. What is the meaning of Aazhi mazhaik anna? Aazhi refers to rain which repeatedly keeps coming in a circular fashion. So Aazhi mazhaik essentially refers to good abundant rain which pours down on all places without any partiality. And Aazhi mazhaik anna refers to the in charge of such rain. So the deity of rain, Aazhi mazhaik anna, actually came down and made himself present when Aandaal was speaking about him. This act shows that any deity, any godly being in the heavens is ready to be at the beck and call of the devotees of Lord Narayana. They are all so respectful of Lord Narayana's devotees that if they are even summoned by them, they would make their presence immediately. And that is exactly what has happened in Aandaal's case. Aandaal spoke about abundant rains and the in-charge deity of rains made himself present immediately to listen to Aandaal and to ask her how exactly does she want this rain to be showered. So Aandaal is very happy looking at the rain god in charge, and she starts speaking to him and telling him how he should shower rain so that this world becomes happy, fertile and abundant with riches. So this pasuram, the fourth pasuram, is about how rains should shower on this world and how the rain god should do it so that the result of the pavai nombu is seen by the world. So she is calling out to Aazhi mazhaik anna. She tells him, Ondru nee kai karavel. Hey rain god in charge, please do not have any reservations in showering rain. Ondru nee kai karavel, meaning do not stop yourself at any point because of some reservation. Meaning sometimes the rain god becomes displeased with some people because of the adharma or the unrighteousness that they are doing. So he decides not to shower rain on those places. But the all-merciful Aandaal says, please do not keep any such reservations. You shower your rain on all places of the world so that everybody benefits And if there is goodness around you, it also gets into you. So please make room for that. Undruni kai karavel, she says. Now, from where is this water of rain to be brought? There's a question. From where does cloud pick up water for showering rain? We all know that. We all know the water cycle. It is from the seas and large water bodies that clouds actually pick up water. Water evaporates and clouds get formed. We know that. So Andal is saying that, O rain god, you make your clouds pick up water from the middle of the sea. Aazhi ulpukku, she says. Here, Aazhi, the word Aazhi, refers to ocean or sea. We saw that in this pasuram, the first Aazhi referred to rain which keeps occurring in a circular fashion. When she said Aazhi mazhaikku anna, that Aazhi referred to rain. Now the second Aazhi, that is the Aazhi which comes in Aazhi ulpukku, refers to oceans or seas. So Aazhi ulpukku, go into the midst of the oceans and pick up water, because that is where you would find water which is completely unpolluted and untouched. So you would have water in the most pure form. So go inside, dive deep into the ocean and take water from there. She's ordering the rain god. So the clouds which would be born by the rain god now would have completely pure water of the best quality. And then you come out from the sea with a beautiful roar, she's saying. Mugundu kodu aatheri. You make an announcement that now it's going to rain, so that people get to know that they are to expect rain now and they would make the necessary arrangements. Many a times, virtuous people do not give claims about what they do. That is also a part of virtue. They do not want to blow their trumpets. For example, Lord Narayana does so much for us. Swami Deshikan says, Arulala Perumal Seyyum Andamila Udaviyellam Alapparare, meaning the kind of help and the kind of grace that the Lord showers on us is completely immeasurable and undefinable. So much He does for us, but all this the Lord does silently. The Lord has given us this birth so that we can think and we can improve and we can go towards redemption of ourselves. Such a big, big grace this is. But the Lord never claims that I have done this for you. So there is a part of virtue that virtuous people do not claim about their virtues. But here, Andal says that you must make an announcement about the virtue that you are going to do. You are going to tell the world that you are going to give them something good. So please come out with a nice, pleasing roar. Mugundu kodu aatheri, she is saying. So when the clouds pick up water from the middle of the sea and come out, they should come out with a bang. Aatheri, she says. And once these clouds come, what is going to happen next? Oodi mudalvan uruvam pol meikaruthu. When people look at the sky should be filled with dark clouds. And how dark should these clouds be? She says, Uri mudalvan uruvam pol mei karuthu. Karuthu refers to black or darkness. And the body of the clouds should be as dark as Lord Narayana. Lord Narayana, who is the cause of the universe. Uri mudalvan, meaning the first cause of the universe, the basic cause of the universe, Lord Narayana. What is his color? His color is black, because black is the color of mercy. Black is the color of origin, from where everything comes up. So you should be like the color of Narayana. Your clouds should have the color of Narayana. Now this is a big honor to the clouds that Andal is giving, because just because the clouds are taking up the color of Narayana, Every time devotees look at the clouds, they are reminded of Narayana. So great saints like Alvars look at clouds and they feel it is the Lord and they start singing about the Lord. Alvar says, Bindu ma malai tavalum megavanda. The Lord is called as Megavanda, the one who bears the color of the clouds. So that is only because that now these clouds have taken up the color of the Lord, that henceforth they are going to be called as equivalent to having the color of the Lord. So it's actually an honor that Andal is giving the clouds by telling them to take up the color of Lord Narayana. Fine, that was the color of the clouds. Now, what next? She says, Paadiyantholudai Padmanabhan kayil aalipol minni. When we have clouds, we have lightning. So, these clouds bearing pure water should also have lightning. And this lightning should be like what she describes. She says, these lightning streaks should be as bright as the discus or the Sudarshana Chakra held by the Lord. And how is this Sudarshana Chakra? This is as bright as millions of suns. So, this cloud-bearing form of the rain god should have lightning as bright as Sudarshana Chakra. Aali pol minni, she said. Now here, this word Aali, which has come for the third time in the Pasuram, refers to the divine discus or Sudarshana Chakra of the Lord. And where is the Sudarshana Chakra of the Lord? Andal is saying, Paliyantholudai Parpanaban Kayil. This Sudarshana Chakra or Aali is present in the divine hands of Lord Padmanabha. And the divine hands of Lord Padmanabha here are described as beautiful, wide, broad shoulders which signify protection to the world. She says, Pari am tol udai Padmanabhan. Tol refers to shoulders. Am tol is beautiful shoulders. And Pariyam tol is refuge-giving beautiful shoulders. When we see a man with broad shoulders and he is somebody who is close to us, we feel that, okay, he is capable of protecting us. So these broad shoulders signify protection that the Lord offers to his devotees. And how is he protecting his devotees? By using this discus or Aazhi or divine chakra against enemies. So, the lightning that is to be borne by these clouds should be as bright and as protective as the Sudarshana Chakra. Many a times lightnings cause damage to crops and houses. She's saying, I don't want anything that will damage this society because of rains. So, the lightning that is associated with you should also be completely risk-free. That is why she is talking about the lightning trying to be like the discus or the Sudarshana Chakra, which will only yield good to the devotees. So thus, she described how the lightning of the clouds should be. Following lightning, what comes? Thunder comes. So she is saying how she wants the thunder to be. Valam puripol nindradirdu. She is saying that the thunder that emanates from these clouds should be as loud as the Lord's conch or panchajanya, shankha. This shankha is called Valampuri. This Valampuri shankha is blown by the Lord for two reasons. One, to warn the enemies that he is going to come. It is said that during the Mahabharata, when Lord Krishna blew his panchajanya, the sons of Dhritarashtra got a massive heart attack. Saghosho Dhartarashtranam Hridayani Vyadarayat. He says, the same Shankha or conch or Valampuri was blown by Lord Krishna when he reached Kundinapura. That is the place where Rukmini's marriage was going to happen. He reached the border of Kundinapura and he blew his conch. And this was heard by Rukmini Devi, and that actually gave such filled happiness to her heart that she was relieved that now she is going to be saved by Lord Krishna. Pratyasannam muhurudara charat panchajanya pranadaha, Swami Deshikan says. Thus, this conch or panchajanya or valampuri gives happiness to the hearts of devotees and gives warning and fear in the hearts of enemies. So she says that these clouds should have the sound of a thunder resembling that of the panchajanya, valampuri or the Lord's divine conch. Fine. Now these clouds are coming with thunder and lightning. Now we see many a times that clouds come with thunder and lightning and just go away like that without giving any downpour. Andal specifically says, please do not do any such thing. Ensure that you are going to give good rains. And your rain should be steady rain without any cloud burst and which would fill up reservoirs completely. And this rain should come like sheets of water or sheets of arrows that would flow out from the bow of Rama, she's saying. Tadade sarga budaita saramalai pol. This malai or rain should be like saramalai. Saramalai is the rain of arrows. And these arrows are getting released from the bow sharga of the Lord. Tadade sarga budaita saramalai pol. Lord Rama's arrows are supposed to be coming continuously from the bow. The sheet of arrows looks like as though it is a continuous process in the sense that one cannot make out that there is a point when Rama's arrow is being released from the bow and a point when that arrow is going and striking the opponent. The arrows are released so continuously that it looks like a string of arrows. And it's not a single arrow that is released at a time, but many arrows in a vertical row. So it actually looks like a sheet of arrows. So Andal describes that the raindrops that are falling from the clouds should be like the sheet of arrows that come out from the bow of Lord Rama. Tara desharga budaita saramalai pol vaala ulaginil peididai. Thus this rain should come down to the earth so that everybody can live happily. Vaala ulaginil peididai, she says. Now, if we look at the instructions given by Andal, she's given all the instructions related to the Lord. She wants the rain-bearing clouds to pick up water from the seas and look like the Lord. And then she wants the clouds to bear lightning like the divine discourse of the Lord. She wants the clouds to have thunder resembling the sound of the conch of the Lord. And then she wants the clouds to pour down rain like sheets of arrows coming from the bow of the Lord. Everything associated with the Lord will only give livelihood, happiness or vaalchi to people. So she's saying, vaala ulaginil peididai. After receiving such detailed instructions, this Lord of rain or the deity of rain, the Arimalaik Anna or Parjanya Devata as he is known, he's humbly folding his hands and asking, okay, shall I start now? Then Andal says, no, wait. Nangalum margali neerada. Let us finish our margali vrata or pavai nobu. Then you can give this rain to the world as a fruit of our vrata so that everybody becomes happy. Magilde lorembavai. This Thiruppavai is called as Sangat Tamil Malai by Andal. Sangat Tamil Malai means something like a complete opera, a set of dance, drama, music and poetry. So we can see that in this particular pasuram, Andal has actually painted a scene which is like a drama where she's instructing how rains are to be showered on this world. So for this poetic beauty of Andal and depth of meaning of her words, let us bow down and say, Andal Thiruvadigale Saranam.